And welcome back, guys, to ARK Survival Evolved Scorched Earth Orc Mode 1.5, where we are on a bird. That is right, we are on Bloodwing. Yes! So I am now level 57. And the tales I have to tell. So basically, last episode we were playing around with our noisy bugger. I decided, let's do a little exploration. And so I ended up recording one episode where we flew around the map and we looked at the different areas and I kind of brought in stuff. And after I watched, I was like, that was kind of boring. I do this sometimes. I make a video and then after I'm done, I watch it over. I'm like, I don't like that. I didn't care for it. So I just cancel it out. It hurts, but sometimes you just have to do that. So I ended up doing a bunch of taming for another episode and ended up taming like a bunch of high level raptors, like 94 to 120. That's right. I found a 120 raptor. And we tamed those up for one episode, and again, I was like, you know what? We've tamed raptors up before. I should do something a little different. I just went a little bit nuts with it. So today, we are starting fresh. So the map. I've explored this map. It's quite large, and I found that there is some diversity in the biomes. You can't really tell until you get flying around and you see the differences more often, but there's some areas where there's, like, no trees and they're just cactuses. Some areas got, you know, the mountains where there's lots of nice metal, crystal obsidian, but no trees hardly. And then, you know, it's nasties. I wouldn't ever recommend living and building on top of a mountain. I'm going to, you know, put an example here pretty soon, but it's just really hard because the way the mountains are all formed, you literally have to build walls all around your duplex or your, you know, complex, because anything could come from the mountain and work its way down, and then it's in your base. So you have to build walls, and you have to build them tall. Otherwise, you're going to have troubles. But otherwise, there's also places where there's no water, and really nice places to build, like, specifically, like, around here. I've seen some of these places over in this direction, where there's these nice little, you know, flat-ish kind of plateau thingies that are kind of cool to build on, because you're safe, you know. You don't have to build walls, because they are your walls, in a sense. And you can build on them, but there's hardly any water right next to them. So you have to have a water source, another way of getting water. And so that's when I came up with an idea. But there is also a really cool mountain that's, like, perfect for PvP. Like, it's all uphill, so you build your base at the top, put auto turrets for the flyers, and then just build layers and layers of walls so that they have to work their way up them. It's kind of cool looking. But anyways, today we are going to show you, and we're going to do some taming a little later, our new secondary kind of base. And this is mainly for getting metal and some other things. And also, it's a really nice location. And I'll explain that in a minute here. As soon as... nailed it. Perch right here. So here you go. We got our little base here. Now, the reasons I picked this location is A, there's two ways to get up to it. There's through that archway. And there's actually through this back way. Now, the back way is nice. It's handy. And it also leads to where all these nice big trees are, where you can get lots of wood. And then, of course, it leads down here, where in case you need some sand for an adobe or something, you can get these rocks with the, you know, a dodicrous. The only downside you have to be careful is, unless you get something that can jump, you have to build a little foundation here with a ramp. Otherwise, they can't get it past this one spot. Right there. So it's kind of good, and it's kind of bad in that sense. Like, watch this guy. Watch this guy. He's not going to be able to get up here. Silly cat. Can't get up here. You can't jump. You can't jump on your own. No, you just run in a straight line, and then you go down the hill, and then you're stuck. Anyways, the other part, this. Look at this. There's nodes literally near our base. There was more. I mined them to get stuff going. I got another dodicrous. There's more nodes over here. They've respawned since I last... been playing, because I've been off taming stuff. And there's a lot of these rocks, which I mentioned before, you hit them with a dodicrous and all you get is stone, which is what I want. I'm tired of having to go, like, near the mountain base just to get, you know, a bunch of stone. Here I don't have to go far to get just stone, because you want to build with stone at least sometimes. Also, this, look at this, we're not too close to the obelisk, so I don't worry about the waverns, because I noticed that when I explored, every obelisk has dragons spawn near it. At least every time I was near one, there was some. But there's also an abundance of other creatures. There's Carnos, Raptors, Marillotops, Parasers, Argies, of course, flying off of the mountain. There's thorny dragons, kangaroos. There's a stone golem I parked somewhere around here. I think right there, someplace. So there's a lot of creatures that you can tame relatively close. And gallimimuses. I even saw some of those new little birds that they just added. I forgot where they're called or where they are, but right over here some. So this is perfect location for that reason. Also, I should mention the reason I wanted a metal base is because I'm thinking we're going to have to get into a little bit higher tech in order to expand outwards and do some other fun stuff. Like, we might have to get auto turrets in case we want to build someplace more dangerous or go someplace more dangerous. Like, imagine you had a Pariser, because it's the only thing that has a platform set on it. We build, like, we tame a nice Pariser, put a platform on it, generator, and like four auto turrets, and just wreak havoc on anything that wants to get to us. But also, this is a cool area because there's a ton of crystal and obsidian over here. These mountains are quite nice, though. I gotta say, there's multiple trails, and if you survive the trails, they lead like literally through the mountains onto the other side of the desert. But over here is this cave, and if you want to do like even go deeper than I did, this is where you want to build your base nearby. Just be careful because there are dragons that spawn around it. But there's nothing but obsidian and crystal in this cave, like nothing else besides regular rocks. I'll get them up for you real quick. But, oh, you see how much crystal's in here? And obsidian. There's no metal, which is kind of weird, but there's so much of everything else. And of course, there's silica pearls in the water, which is nuts. How much of it is in just one cave? Otherwise, it's kind of hard to find on a cave safely. But then you come out here, and there's more metal, and there's more nasties and stuff. But of course, we don't want to live out here. It's just, it's not nice. But anyways, I'll go ahead and show you our little base, and then we're going to go tame us a T-Rex. I have to go build some stuff. I forgot. I got done building this base, and then I quit for a while, so I haven't... This is why you don't build no mountains. You don't want to build... Like, this is okay spot because there's not a lot of stuff spawning, but this is why you don't build next to or below one real close. All these things will fall into your house if you do. I guarantee it. Like, there's another arch there. There was a lightning dragon flying around, and it was wrecking stuff left and right. Like, it was going after Argies even. Alright, let's go back down here. So, the reason I built right here is because it's relatively close, but relatively far enough. You have to worry about, you know, certain things. And the way that it's built or laid out, I got those walls so that I could literally, if I wanted to be even more safer, but I don't think I'll need it. I haven't had an issue yet. I could build a second layer of walls and another gate, and I'd be completely safe. Because nothing spawns on the arch, I've seen. And I have my walls far enough back that if they did and they fell forward, they'd land right in front of the gate. And I'll show you real quick here. That's another tip if you're going to build here. Otherwise, it's a decent spot. So over here, like I said, I haven't seen anything spawn on this area too much. But if they fell in, they'd land, hopefully, right here, at least for the most part. And then, of course, I got creatures in here that would take care of them. And then there's just not much that spawns over here. But if you wanted to, you could put another wall, you know, between that rock and that wall. And you'd be pretty safe. But I haven't actually seen too much on this side. I don't know why. I just haven't. Alright, so the reason I mentioned we want to build with stone is because I found something interesting. I swear we're going to tame something today. We're going to go tame a T-Rex. But, and we want to give you this in case you didn't know. So I did a little test, and when you use a metal pick and you hit a piece of stone wall, you do 1 damage out of 10,000. You use the same pick and I hit this wall and it did that much damage out of 6,000. So the adobe is not as dirty as stone, which is understandable, but you definitely need some kind of adobe structure in your base in order to protect you from the elements. Like, I'm still missing some flooring, I just realized. I'm missing a lot of flooring, holy cow. Although, I could do foundations. Yeah, I have to do foundations, that's why I quit. So if you wanted to, I would recommend doing like a living quarters with, you know, camps, fires, some kind of water source. I got a little tank in the back here. I definitely recommend building like lots more of those because they only hold 200, the stone ones. But you want to do your outer shell like this with the stone, so it's a lot more sturdy. You know, if you have metal, go for it. But I swear I just heard the fighting music going. Like it just started to kick in a little bit. I don't see anything though. Oh, there it is. There's something trying to get through my gate. Thorny dragon. What level are you, thorny dragon? Level 56? No, ouch! You just gotta get off my property right now. Get off my property. Because you just messed up all my dinos. Now they all want to fight you. That's why you got a back door. You seriously, go away. Go away. You made me shoot my door now. Son of a gun. I didn't do any damage, but it's the principle. There I go. Just trying to get that headshot. But yeah, it's a decent spot. 1 second. Gotta get some food and I gotta get some water. But like I said, there's a lot of metal nodes relatively close. Just to show you, I only hit like 3 or 4 groups just in front of this gate area, and this is all the metal I got. Of course, my rates are a little bit higher, but oops, not there. There's quite a bit of metal around here. 277 in each of those. So anyways, I'm gonna get some stone structure stuff, because I also, when I was exploring, I found out there's only like one area I've ever seen T-Rexes. So we're gonna go to that one area and we're gonna go tame us one of those T-Rexes. And I'll be back. Okay, ignore my previous comment about getting up here. You don't actually have to go that way. I mean, if you walled this off, you would. But you could just literally go right up here. I thought it was a little steeper than that, but no. Just right for you to get up there. Also, I forgot that I tamed up some direwolves when I was taming up a new Ankleo and Dodicrys. Just because it'd be easier, I think, than walking from here. From other places. It's not that far, but it just would have saved time. And here we are. This is like the only area I have ever seen a T-Rex. There's one down here eating something right now, so that's a perfect sign. But we're going to do something. So this is actually a decent area, by the way, because it's cool when it gets a heat storm. There's some stuff we can harvest around here, metal, silica pearls, wood, stone. So if we need to expand on this little, it's just mainly going to be someplace safe for me to go to while we're taming up these T-Rexes. But there's lots of areas we could put, but I'm thinking, and I thought about this, we're going to put it right over here on this rock. Because otherwise I have to worry about building walls or an actual base. And like I said, all we're doing is taming. So I'm not going to be here that long, or that often, hopefully. But if we have to, we can always build something like right here would be a good spot. Because all I have to do is, you know, put some walls, but I'd have this nice little bluff I could shoot down from, put a ladder or something. But we're going to put over here on this rock. Right here by this other T-Rex. So there's water nearby, so I don't have to worry about that. There's some parasers. You go down that way, and there's more parasers that way than if you go this way. But right around here should be a pretty good spot. Also, I forgot. I got some cool stuff from a drop. I got another tent for emergency purposes, and I got an oil pump. I found a blueprint one time, but I found an actual oil pump from, I think it was a gold one. So let's go ahead and take those out. I don't know if I have enough ceilings. Might have to do some more building off camera, but we'll see. Should get us at least decent. So the plan is I want to build kind of like right here with these and then have them stretch out so that I can put ladders going down. So I think right as far as I can possibly get, really. I'm not too worried about being square of anything. That was the wrong one. Shoot! I wanted to do this one. There we go. Now, do I want to build down that way or down this way? I think we could do the overhang this way. Let's not mess these up, because I only have 4. And then all I want to do is put a ladder go straight down here, which I think we got plenty of. Yes, we do. I don't even need these pillars. That's right. You're going to be my buddy pretty soon here. What are you? Level 36? That's not a bad starting T-Rex. Don't eat my new floating. Alright, throw this. Wait, no. I got one of these. And then we're going to throw that pump on, and we're going to test that too. Got some necessities. Oh, before I forget, I didn't bring any beds. So I'm just going to make some sleeping bags. Probably make at least two. Maybe three. They are T-Rexes. Hopefully, oh shoot, I can't make it. Can he? He is really wanting to get up here though, isn't he? I'm gonna throw those on the ground for now. So I can finish this little jaunt. Alright. I'm gonna put these here for now, and then we're gonna stick these. He's persistent! And then we'll throw these on the hotbar, and then throw this on the hotbar, and then this extra stuff can go in there. Okay, let's do this. I'm gonna slap these down right here. And I know what those are for. Alright. So, first things first, pick those up. And then we're gonna probably get this blue drop. Blue drops might have something useful. I don't know if I mentioned this, but if it got the yellow ring, that's for Scorched Earth stuff. So, if you're looking for only Scorched Earth things from the airdrops, grab those for sure. Let's quickly over here get this real quickly. Real quickly. Like, the water sources, they're not bad to build around, to be honest. There is a little bit of metal, and there is some stuff, and there is, of course, water, but I noticed that there's more nasties, like, particularly more snakes and dire wolves I've seen more often, and terror birds, so you have to worry about all those little things getting you. So if you got a T-Rex, you're gonna be fine, but until you get to that point. Now, before I forget, let's get these built, so I don't have to worry about dying and not being able to get up here. That way I can leave my bird too. Okay, if I can just come in for the landing. And then hold it. Oh! Is it because, oh, it's not close enough to the... That don't make sense. I can build it on one side, but not the other. I can build it there, but I can't build it here. Where I want it to go. Alright, game, I see how it is. Let's see. Then we get another one. I don't know if we're gonna make it. Excuse me, just hold still. I'll get to you in one moment. We might get close enough. I might have to build like a little thingy down here. Like, this is an ideal spot. Oh, you know what? Let me just do this off camera. This is taking longer. I almost got it. This is so wonky. Like, I got almost close enough to where I could get to it from down below. Like, it's just one short, but because of the rock, it gets in the way now. I guess I could have used some pillars, and I could have just done it, but I think... I don't know. I think I'll just do a little platform down there to get to it, to be honest. But let's do this. Let's go, and we're going to have to use... Before I forget, I should have some more stuff in here, right? Yes, I do. Let's go ahead and grab some of those. I have arrows. Let's do this. Let's go actually take half of this, just in case. I remembered also I got a sleeping bag down there by that water part, but look, he's perfectly stuck. Is it he or is she? I can't remember now. Oh, I say that and now he's going to turn around. He's still stuck. But I have to wait till 65. I forgot darts are 65. So that's a long time. But hopefully he stays still. Oh yeah, right in the nose. We should be able to trank him. T-Rexes get stuck so easily. I don't know what it is about them, but... Oh yeah, just go in that little hole now. Because that's much better than where you were before. Oh, I got you with that one too. We're just going to sit here and just trank you until you fall asleep. And then I'll go down there. Yeah, should be pretty easy, but I did some testing. Like, I tamed so many raptors off camera because I ended up, I found some high level ones. I don't remember, I don't think I mentioned this. I found a 120, a 112, a 104, and there was a 94 with a 120. And that ravine, I was doing this test because it got real hot, and I wanted to see if I went in that ravine where that cave is. Like, if it would cool me down, and it only works near the entrance because of the water nearby. I'm gonna let those soak in because I don't think he's gonna move anywhere. And so it doesn't help when you go deeper, but I ended up going deeper just to test, and I found that 120. I was like, that's amazing. Let's see if I can get a headshot here. Oh, he moved at the last second there. Oh, he's gonna come closer now. He must not get any very close. He's getting towards me. Like, we could go higher. I think it would be too bad. I gotta get more scorpions. I only got like two or three. No, I got three and two of them are males, so that doesn't help much, but we need to get some trank darts. I think it'll be more efficient. Otherwise, this is gonna take so many arrows to take out a heavier, higher level. Oh, now you're stuck again. Higher level T-Rex. So when we get darts, I'll go for a higher one with kibble for sure. But for now, this will do. And I'm just gonna keep shooting this guy until he falls asleep. And he's down for the count. That took almost all my darts. Alright. Let's see if I can retrieve just a couple. I mean, it'd be kind of neat if you could get these back. Maybe a few of them. And there was a chance that they could be trank darts again. But it makes sense. It's not that hard to get trank darts. Alright, so there we go. He's got 3,080 health, 504 stamina, 570 weight, 115 melee, and of course oxygen and that stuff we don't care about. But we're going to go ahead and we're going to let them get real hungry because, like I said, just the meat spoils so quickly. Going to go home, get some preserving salt. Oh, I forgot to mention that. We went in the desert looking and we found salt and I was like, oh great, now I have to go all the way out here just to find salt. There's salt, really. Really close to our house. Like, I don't even know why I didn't think about looking around this mountain for it, but on the other side of this thing, there's a salt note. I can't believe it. I was like just flying by one day. I picked up a drop and I was coming back, and here is salt right there. Not that far from our house. So we don't even have to go into that crazy, crazy desert just to get salt. There's some right there. But we're going to need preserving salt, because that's a lifesaver. Just being able to keep the meat a little bit longer. And yeah, we're going to starve this guy out. And I leveled up, fixing my armor, so we've got two more levels to go. No way, another one? Alright. I thought it was a yellow one. We have to go do that. It just reminded me. We have to go try these out. I got two of these puppies now. I don't know if we need anything else, but I'm pretty sure we don't. We just slap them on something, and we'll tons of oil. I don't know, like, the only thing I could think of is gasoline for generators, but there's windmills. So we want to get metal, because I kind of do want to try some of these new things out. Like, there's a flamethrower and a chainsaw, but we need a fabricator for that. So that's the biggest thing. And then there's the windmill I'd like to test out, because I'm thinking it's, like, I don't know how it's going to work, but I'm certain there's some areas where windmills are more efficient, so I don't know, like, there's no actual wind, I hear it, but there's no actual effects, so I don't know how that works. All we have to do is fly out here real quick, and there's some oil nodes over here we can put these on, I think. So yeah, this is one of those areas I was talking about where you definitely notice kind of a, I think I mentioned this, difference in the biomes. There's, like, no trees except for dead ones. There's some cactus things, but they don't give much wood. And then there's just tons of bones. Look at them all. There's nothing but bones up here. It's kind of weird. It's like a boneyard, but I'm not quite sure of what. I think it's all like carnivores, it seems like. I don't think I've noticed anything else, but here's one and another one right here. So let's go ahead. What level is this carno? For giggles, 16. If it wants to tango, we'll tango. But let's see, let's go ahead and take the other one out. Oops. Oh, they do stack, sweet. And then we're gonna see, it should just plop. Yeah, automatically just wants to snap right to it. There we go. Oil pump for free. Free oil for life. This thing's really gonna get close to me, isn't it? Look at those. Those are like spine cords, vertebrae. Those are massive. All right, here he comes. Alright, get out of that. Look at these things, they're massive. Just massive. Alright, he's gonna tangle with that. So let's see, these are cool. They weren't that hard to make. I joke because I didn't have... Oh, can we pick him up though? Is the main question. Access, demolish. No, we can't. So we could get like free resources from these. Oh my gosh, he's already got two oil on it. Got 15 slots, that's 1,500 oil we have in these things. That's a lot. Actually, I think I'm gonna kill this thing. Just because I want the XP so I can get a T-Rex saddle quicker. Don't kill it, Ankylo. In fact, I'm sorry, Ankylo, but you're gonna have to go too. There we go. I got them both! Oh my gosh! Trip double kill. Like, I knew I was gonna get them, but I didn't think I would. At the same time. Alright, guys. That's cool, though. We'll have to look up. I don't know if... I'm gonna look it up on the wiki. I don't feel like learning them, since I don't think I'm ever gonna need that much oil. And now that I got two of these, and I can probably get more. Look at this, already four. They're very quick. Like, we're never gonna need oil ever again. No more jug bugs for us. But I'm gonna go tame us up with that T-Rex. I'm gonna look on the wiki to see how much these things cost. How much money we just saved. And, yeah. And here comes a storm coming, so... I'll be back. Alright. This thing's been sitting there for a while. Got a bunch of meat on me, and hopefully we can get it off and onto it before it goes bad. But yeah, I've been flying around quite a bit. Ended up doing some exploring, and I found some cool stuff. And I looked up on the wiki, and that pump... Spam it. Spam it! I probably overkilled it, but that's fine. The pump costs 75 metal, 25 crystal, 25 electronics. So that's quite pricey for two of those that we just got. And then they produce one oil every 20 seconds. And after a while, they will actually stop working. So you have to replace them onto that node. The nodes will stay there forever. Oh, I had enough. Very nice. I had to go hungry. I was like pretty hungry. There's a dossier. And then, let's see, did you have any left over I could cook up, maybe? He had two pieces. Ooh, I killed three parasers. That was good. Good timing. Alright, so, here we go. We got our first Rex. He's level 53 now. Got some good levels. There's a 44 I might end up going to do. Off camera, of course. Because it's going to be a while again. But it's stuck in a rock. It's like, this is too good to pass up. A level 44. I don't have to chase it or anything. He's got to shoot it in the butt a lot. Well, hopefully in the head. Get some bonus shots. But there we go. We got us our first T-Rex. Now, what are we going to do with the T-Rexes? I've been just kind of willy-nilly names. No themes this time. Let's check your colors out. You're kind of orangish. And kind of blackish. Gosh, I know there's probably something to go with you. That is a color, nice color scheme, to be honest. What should we call you? What should we call you? We're just gonna go with, orange for now. I don't know. Weren't you glad I didn't call you banana? There we go, guys. I'm gonna go, actually, real quickly here. I'll put you on sit. So we got, like, literally one level. I am almost level 69, or 59, sorry. So we need one more level, and we'll be able to ride that guy. Be able to get prime much easier. I figure because this is a huge map, sometimes you just can't get prime very easily. We'll probably end up eventually doing like a system where we use him. Like, we go to oasis. Oasis are the best places to find parasers. Just go there, kill a bunch of them, and then using the T-Rex. And then, oh no way, another pump. What else did I get? Oh, I got a ramshackle whip. Blueprint, that's not bad. We might just go ahead and go stick that on something, I don't know. And you know, you will use like more salt, the T-Rex, to get prime, and then throw it on a bird to fly it to wherever we need to. But eventually we won't need to, because if I get enough scorpions, which I'll do off camera as well, then we can make kibble for T-Rexes. So the higher level T-Rexes we can do fairly easier, just sit there and wait. Raptors, I can't do anything about that. But Carnos, I do have some Ankylos already going. So we could do kibble for those if we find any. I haven't really found any high level Carnos, but that's fine. And there we go. Pause that before it goes off. There's another T-Rex just spawned in over here. A level 20 white one. Another male. We might end up doing that one. I don't know. Or we'll let you kill it. Should we do a little first jaunt? I mean, it's level 20. I could always assist. I don't really need level 20. Let's do it. Before we end this episode, let's go test drive this new guy. be his first kill. I know there's something I'm thinking off the tip of my brain that's orange and black like that. I just can't think of it right now. But Orange is gonna be his name for now. Alright, Orange, you ready for this? Oh, he's going after a dire wolf. This isn't a very even fight then. I'm not even gonna assist with that one. I'm just gonna that dire wolf pretty much. Oh, he got the kill at least. Did a number on the level 76, no wonder. Holy cow. There we go, guys. Did some ooh, Sabertooth, assistance! Assistance, Orange! Assistance! Get it! Orange is gonna be like level 100 by the time we get home, guys. It's gonna be amazing. Well, there we go. Yep, almost level 60, and then we can ride him. And I will see you guys next time.